and welcome back to another saga. I think today we'll end this story. Needs boys are distinguishing a game and starting to play when you approach her. Are they getting plenty to eat? I think so. They still have enough energy to get into trouble. It's for the best. Hopefully they can stay children as long as possible. I hope so too. Before allowing you to refuse, she puts a spoon and a bowl with cooked eggs in your hands. Now, you have to try these. It's a family recipe. You take a bite. They're good, but you don't taste anything special. What do you think? They just taste like eggs. Her eyes look down with embarrassment. Oh, I mean, there's nothing wrong with them. Retro starts smiling. They really are just eggs. My mother used the family recipe story on each of us kids, one time or another when we wouldn't eat. She tried to guilt you into eating. She tried anything and everything to raise us, feed us, keep us from getting into too much trouble. Now with my voice, I understand why. I'm sure you had a bit of that quiet, even more so now with this caravan. I doubt they're thinking you wouldn't try to keep everyone alive. You think back on all the choices you've made. Just know that we understand and appreciate it. Eventually. Thanks, Reed. Sorry, that's not a lot of food we can get. Are we still? We only have 5 days worth of food. That's very little. Let's leave. The cars just start moving away from the village when you hear Agiota. Papa? Turn to see when she is looking in gasp. From the east, over ground you recently crossed, comes a large number of missing clansmen, fighters, and war. Is that Ruga? Someone asks. The front of the group is the former governor of Boar's Guard. Husbands run out to their wives and children scream in excitement from their parents they believe to be dead. You make your way out to greet the group as well, but Ruga holds up his hand as you kneel. It's as hard as ever to read the governor's face, and Dagger naturally says nothing.
I hope you didn't get all cleaned up for me. Was it too much for you to just die when a serpent struck?
You seem to be hard to kill as well.
Remember that.
Your tone is not exactly threatening, but not warm either. You decide what to say next. What happened to you after the serpent attack?
I might ask you the same. Dagger and I tried to save a few families before running.
You glance at the silent guard, but he neither confirms nor denies the story.
The old wood was like a maze, but we finally escaped, picking up others along the way. We waited for you until we were damn near out of food. I started pushing everyone hard, only sending a couple of men to Tolia for supplies.
The same with us, but our scouts never returned. Ruga scratches his scar around his neck.
That's all, but neither did ours. But here we are, the most of us still alive.
Thank you for collecting the rest of our clan.
Our clan? Is that really what we are? One clan?
Believe it or not, that's exactly what we are.
I suppose we'll see. You won't be the only ones seeking shelter in Arborank. Families have long memories. Hatred can span generations. I'm surprised if petty arguments and bad blood rule the day.
Do you need rest before we move on?
That's up to the clansmen and fighters. I'm only a servant of the people.
It's so strange, like he's been rehearsing this statement along with that unnerving grin. I'm sure you could use a bite at least, if not a few hours to close your eyes.
If that's what they want.
You glance at Dagger and get nothing but his stone gaze in return. I'm going to speak to some of the others.
before you know. Dagra shifts slightly. You're shocked by how such small change puts you on a guard. Relax, Rook. I wanted to offer a treaty of sort between us. As much as I hate to admit it, you've done a decent job with these people. You stare at him, waiting for the insult. Laughs. I might not have agreed with all of your decisions on the river, or in Lunda, or in the old wood, but you did all right. Look, now I'm an ass. I know you weren't thrilled to see me arriving, but I'm pleased you're here. Now, get us to the capital. We're so close. Your ass sound is stubborn. Let's not make this uncomfortable. He and his guard head towards the village for food and sleep before you head out. And we have even less food now. So, unless someone's on the forge, we're gonna start. Strumming from Aleon's song from a large number of your clansmen surprises you. A vowel stands in the center of them, blushing. It scarce 200 here! A vowel beside you shout. The rest of the caravan is fun to check with commotion. Congratulations, Scary, but we should keep moving. Your sobering reminder kills the mood and some give yourself looks. Your time for a smile, someone says. I hope Arbor is better than this, others can keep it. Everyone keeps moving. Okay, they found something. The surrounding woods look promising for a game, and you could use a bit of solitude. Soon, dear tracks guide you, but in the gloom, the peace is already formed. Scanning the woods, you hear anything of. As you approach the deer, you can tell the kill was recent. A black stone, half the size of your fist, lies beside the animal. Pick it up, knowing it to be going to be a dredge weapon. A rustle in the underbrush in Barrio's two howls could immediately create deep noises. They are communicating, then one lashes out and attacks you. Okay, I'll wait for you. I don't think I can create old worms and prey. Oh, thanks. Oh, wait. Once I can move so that I can shoot them, I will. As the dreadful order from arrive. Not bad, Aaron says, pulling up one of the dread bodies, a child in his lap knows the same. That's enough, leave them alone. They've killed enough of ours, haven't they? The woman asks. Do you think they feel bad about it? I think it has been cheered the argument. I don't know what they feel, you say, but they weren't looking for a fight, they were hunting, same as me. I'm unsure what to make of the reward. Take the deer, come on, let's get moving. They all agree with this statement. The water in nearby streams is gradually turning a bright green in places. It looks like a gore from the serpent's wounds. Dead fish are spotted in the dozens, floating by in the faster moving sections. Some clansmen have fallen ill, others are feeling the effects of only drinking milk. When a few of us spill a section of clear water, the entire caravan gets excited, but the giants hold them back and tell everyone to listen. A faint tune is written across the water. From the water. Word whispers that, what's it mean? Is it safe? I don't care, I'm thirsty. Feel a few burrows will boil it first. People complain of having to wait, but the first part of caution. Fires are started and water is boiled. The result is quite a few burrows of clean, fresh water. It satisfies most everyone's thirst, but not enough to bring cheer. No one seems to know when the tune from the water stopped playing. The caravan slows at the side of the field gate bridge. In front of it is a large army of horseborn formation, weapons drawn. Skadach, are these your people, your clan, or herd? Skadach shakes his head but doesn't speak, his eyes scarred and hard. Hakon calls for shield walls as a precaution. Just as she walks, a single javelin flies from the center of the horseborn army. Everyone watches it arc through the air and stab the ground only yards from him. Ground rumbles as the horse can charge. Please, get through and break. Something equipped with something. Yep. Oh, and now we can deploy them however we want. Yeah, let's go. 48. We learn we are strong. What? Wait. Oh, there's a crack, so I don't know if I will be able to move. Yeah. Ben Kalbren. Look over here. One gray shield move. Okay, congratulations, you played yourself. And we'll try to block them. No. Earth tries a keyword. I really hate Oddleaf for some no real reason. I should fall once we get rid of her there later. We've done that earlier. A slight, cream-colored horsebone with flaxen hair steps out of the ranks of the wounded. Her blue war paint stands out against her otherwise yellow coloration. The remaining horsebone should deference to her. She says a few things in the foreign tongue of her people, but stops when she says you do not understand. Forgiveness, she says fluently. I speak to you, you have my weapon. Sorry for fight, not know it you. She speaks your language with confidence. What do you mean and who are you? I lead herd, I am. The next word is long, shrill and confusing, but certain sounds stand out. Canary? Canary smiles and stamps the ground recently with a hoof. That's easy, canary, yes, and you? Rook. Good greetings, our story tell a stranger who come help us. You two like that walk around for far. I kind of feel ready. She puts the horsebone in your arms. That doesn't make me the stranger in your stories. You're not in belief, we believe. We follow you and join your herd. Why? She uses a slew of sounds in her native language before translating. When sun stops and planes break and a god appears, follow two legs that walk around far. There's our story. We true you see these things. The sun has stopped and I've seen the ground breaking, but could I talking about? Large snake, not from this plane. The serpent. It certainly could be a god. You have seen the god too. You know these signs. You lead us, we follow. Canary looks at you with a steady gaze instead of the constant movement you experience with Daedric. Warn her that not everyone likes horsemen. Most of the horsemen we've met have caused us harm, including you. Many of my people won't want to be new people. Not today, but different day. Let's fight, but forget. Humans remember things a long time. Draw even longer. Heard the belief say that we follow you, heard go strong. She bows again, motions to her people, and all the horsemen joining us at a respectful distance. Please tell me brought some food with you? No. There's some place we can come, but there's something we can do. Can you show me something? Oh, last session. I'm ready. Use the war horn to recover willpower. Okay, let me hold things. Use war horn. Does this work? Tail worth telling, so this is a little. Turn almost random. In a single hit, in the end. Defeat 10 enemies. Defeat all enemies. 8, 12. Well, that's easy, does it count? Yeah. Sorry. Old belief. We can't really arc. Lightning doesn't use for that. I don't want to look taken. Let's see, tell worth telling. Look, during every tour, a strength enemy has over Alec's gives this one is strength damage. Routine over on him.
Í dag skal varin heiður ætta vorna.
I have no idea whether it worked properly or not. Sometimes those skills are so strange. In me. Just the explanation is strange. Over here. No. Wait for 9? Okay, that was possible. Oh, wait. Easy. So, a tale worth telling on. Warhorn. Oh. What the heck? Need to kill her. So take one more.
Vertu þinn eigin guð í orðstu.
Here and use Tempest and Tool. Oh, you're still alive. 11, and you're going first. Nice. This guy's next. No Ivor is there. Unfortunately. He's more of a threat.
I
think we done all. Yeah. That's a lot. If only we could buy food with it right now. That would be perfect. We can't. And we'll starve. Oh, thanks.
They say the moon and stars are always visible when you look at Loega's Godstone. How can that be true?
So we are starving either way. Spirit, the stars, her eyes, allows us plucking a few strings of an instrument. Lauga, the god of beauty, and all. Well, a thing that happened at night, the scroll feels. The ghost may be dead, but perhaps the prays to Lauga and thank him for her piety. The scroll is not the only one smiling. A quick look around reveals Grand's failed caravan. I see why Abarant has grown so quickly over the years, you say, and the scroll laughs. A truth spoken in front of Lauga's Lauga's stone is supposed to ripple through the night, either threatening a little girl's result or carrying away undesired affection. Well, skips away to Lauga's wife. In the shadow of Lauga's godstone, Oddleaf taps on the shoulder. Incredible, isn't it? The godstone? Or us, maybe, Dragon? Both, I guess. Jump on down, Luke. We deserve our reward. Seeing everyone here is a reward enough. Oddleaf cocks an eyebrow. I honestly can't tell if you're shy, dim-witted, or not interested, so let's speak clearly. I've been fond of you since I was a little girl. It's probably why Aldis couldn't stand me. But here we're here now, after everything. Under Lauga's godstone, we shouldn't have to be lonely. You're right. You take your hand, it's strong from daily tasks, it's somehow softer than yours. I'm glad you're willing to give it a try. Oddleaf means the image of beauty. She begins leading you away from everyone else. Oh, you look? Yes. Don't make me track you down again. You're the hunter. Others see you smiling and watch the two of you disappear. People will talk, but who cares? And today, we starve. We have one day with... Oh, where did you get it?
Finally, we made it. But why are so many camped outside the walls? They must have seen the darkness approaching.
Wind ripples across times which multiply the closer you get to Arborang, dangle to the pass, and it is clearly not all from yawks. Rattling coughs mixed with the workers' laughter. Small fights break out for no apparent reason. Curious eyes grow wide as they spot the fell and horse war. Mothers grab their children and man their weapons. Governor Ruga and Dagger step away from the caravan without warning. He seems familiar with a few of the men who have gathered around and soon sharing drinks, stories, and disgusted looks at the hardcore. Various clan banners snap and whip in the wind. You recognize the heraldry of Karl Schuss from Aleo's tales and Strand's banner from previous talks with Ubin. There are even two cracksman banners, but by the muddy appearance. You also notice the division between each clan. There is no mixing or unity. I'll push ahead, Priscilla says. My father will want to see me and I'll be able to find out what exactly is going on here. You're assigned a few fighters escorting through the crowds towards the walls. All Adagan's people are here, you hear a woman from your corner shout. I have to check on him. Others are finding familiar clans and kin as well, slowly drifting from your banner. Bring them here. Bring Adakan and the others to us. Some of the folks around the fires look half-starved and gladly join, making their way toward the supply carts or pack their meager possessions and fall in line. I don't have any food. Where the crowd is the most dense in volume and numbers, the caravan comes to a stop. Ahead, you notice a sharp line where the tents and people stop. The ground beyond is pinned with arrows and not much else. A few hundred yards of empty space between these people and Abraham's walls. What is this, you ask, confused by all you are taking in. That's the peaceful bit, and all the fighters are seeing. He looks the type who has seen enough things to lack enthusiasm for much of anything. The king's men can kill us from the walls and we can't kill them from here. But what's caused the fighting, you ask? The man smiles, his face unaccustomed to action. Come on, Sandrslayer. It's the same damn thing that causes every fight. They've got something we want. King's got food and protective walls. We're starving with our asses facing that rolling darkness. His words deal you a heavy blow. So Abraham said war? The man laughs a little laugh. That's putting it lightly. From what I can tell, this is the worst of our kind. You brought the last of the Vaal and even dragged in some of his Forsmore. This fights for survival. Winter lives. Winner lives, losers gone forever. His laugh turns into hysteria and you leave unsettled. There's a market. The yokes are tended in tents aligned as best as possible. Some are repairing their armor, others look anxious to talk to various clans. The Vaal King's eyes scan the field as he approaches. I want to know what's going on here as much as you, he said, but we better find a way to defend our gear and supplies. These older clans could form a mob if they discover we have food. We've got an issue, Olive says. I don't know why, but the other clans don't like the Horseborn, or the Vaal for that matter. They're starting trouble when I'm going to stop it. Go with Olive to stop the troublemakers. We don't have any food to be stolen from us. Skadach and his weapon drawn, and a few Vaal are sending evil with shields up. Humans and gnomes are hurling every sort of course at them. What's the problem here? The problem is you brought a bunch of animals with you and don't have them tied up properly, a man shouts. The birds want to laugh, bark and whip ropes in the air. You hear the fog growing. Growl. The man glances at you and he's about to look in your eyes. Back away or we won't stop until each of you are dead. Some of the fighters scored. He's bluffing, says the leader. Besides, what could a shepherd and a bunch of farm animals do to us? Looked the man in the eye. I'm the Sandra Slayer from Skullgrim. What do you think I can do? The fighters turn as one and flee and you enter the heart of the caravan. As soon as you find a stump in which to sit, you look up to see Rugarton to the caravan. Backed by Dagger and nearly 50 fighters, the former governor approaches your camp. Everyone looks toward the two of you, more curiosity than concern. I've discovered what these battle signs are all about, he says. The king's shut his people out. These clans are here to see that he feeds and protects his people as he is supposed to, and they've chosen me to lead that cause. He laughs at your incredulous look. I'm just as surprised, but I need to talk to you in private. You nod, and the two of you enter a large empty tent. The tent flaps close, leaving you and Yuga alone, both armed. This is insane, isn't it? Can you believe what's happening here? I'm not clear on what's happening here. I wasn't making that stuff up outside the king. He really has shut all of us out. It started a few months ago when he started stockpiling food and slowing trade. Once the wealthy families were all pulled inside the walls, he shut the gates. The only thing he said is that he can feed everyone. Oh, and his archers fire on everyone who gets close. Watch Ruga closely while deciding what to say. So you plan to break down his walls? That's the last thing I want to do. We need those walls to stop the dredge and whatever else is coming behind him. But if we have to destroy them, we will. Maybe the menders inside can repair any damage. There might be ways past these first few walls, but the black wall? They won't just shake his head. To what end? That's what the upcoming battle aims to find out. You want to go to war to ask the king a question? No, I want to go to war to make the king answer a few questions. Like, why would he leave his people outside the walls to starve? Wait, how did you come to lead the clans? Borsgard was the largest human town next to the capital. You don't come governor of a place like that without certain skills and powerful friends. And what are those certain skills? The governor just smiles. So, this war is unavoidable. Probably. I officially meet with the king in a few hours, so either come to an agreement or pull our banners from his. I won't be surprised if you're invited too. This the mighty Thunder Slayer and an army. If so, make your decisions carefully. His tone is not exactly threatening. Not exactly. We move to the tent flaps and both of you open them simultaneously so the whole fight breaks out. Skadach and Deidru pace nervously, keeping the distance from humans, Varl, and other horsemen. Your egg patrols around the two a short distance away, leading to a baby. Is everything okay? Many months, more than we know, live. You stop to look around at the thousands of tents in the fields and hundreds of homes beyond the capital's wall. I am from a small village. I'm not used to seeing so many people either. Maybe hurt to beat. So maybe I was hungry. Isn't that more easy if it hurt? Skadar stomps the ground and says a few shrill notes to Deidre before turning to you. Deidre forgets we are not of same thinking as us. If you think Big Hurt is right, we will be think Big Hurt is right. But what do you think is right, Skadar? The male horseman looks up at Abraham for a few moments while swishing his tail and thought, I think Big Herd kick each other in small fields. Those Aberon. Small fields behind walls. We find them for talking and offer them a few common ones before departing. Yeah, because we can't offer them food. The former Kragsman is trying to lure something out of hold a small piece of dried meat on a string. He leaves it dangling by his side while standing on top. It looks like you're keeping busy. I'm playing Fox and Harry Vole. Do you think Fox has ever played Trigvee and Vole? No. Trigvee looks disappointed. Do you have any ideas on how to keep two groups from killing each other? Any powders or relics or crazy skins? He reaches into his tunic and grabs something, pauses, reuses whatever it is, and shakes his head. People kill each other every day. Just enjoy the show! But if it comes to war, I don't think either side really was out of it. Trigvee thinks about what Josh is saying, tapping a fingernail against his teeth, looks at his finger, sneers, and spits. Killing kings require a lot of lives. It's just as easy to kill clansmen instead. Either way, some will praise you and others will throw a dunk at your face. Oh, you could collect all the dunk in the giant hill, stand on top of it, and be your own king. As you watch him crouch back down the hall, you wonder what possesses you to speak to him. The skald is tying a dried strip of cloth into his daughter's hair, but sends her off today, as you knew. We've come all this way for war. With luck, I might change their minds. And be the reed that could stop the wind. You've got a lyric for every moment, don't you? Of course, plenty before has been in a similar situation and written about it. We only think our lives are in need. And if peace is not an option, is there a skald song for that? Plenty, but I'll tell you what I do. Save the families who can save themselves. I can't imagine if my wife and children were left out here, like they don't deserve the same protection as others. Aya's words flood and flows as you walk away. Can we have any food? Do you have some food? But maybe 6 is a day worth of food. So we could get 10, 15 days of food. Interesting. I just want to check something. Before you head toward the large tent, Olive stops you. Are you certain you're ready for what could happen out there? Your work looks as infectious. The king may be a decent man, but I doubt he'd keep his form by always following the rules. I'm prepared for whatever the king inclines to decide. I'm glad to hear the confidence in your voice, Olive says. Just be careful. I'll be back here with the rest of the clan if you need me. You smile and make your way past the line of clans from mocking the boundary of the peaceful bee. The voices coming from under the tent are loud, animated.
Best we could.
You've done well, and I thought I'd see my son again.
Well, we've all had easier journeys. The king's cheerful little lessons. He's about to say something when he sees you approaching.
Who's this?
Well met, King Maynoth, and Rookwood from Skogru. Wins the sword.
Father, this is the Sandra Slayer I told you about.
King Maynoth knows, but is staring at Haken from under heavy brows.
It pains me to hear you have lost so many of your hardy warriors, Haken. But tell me, where's Jorun's kingdom, Vognir?
Vognir died, protecting his son. I was Vognir's kingdom. With Jorun's death at Einarthof, I'm king of the few remaining Varl. The king says nothing, contemplating the news.
Your walls are the last hope for my people, no sense in denying it.
I understand. And of course you'll have refuge here. The least I can do for bringing my son back alive. To be tight, but I'm sure we're gonna find a place for you.
King Maynoth, Rook is here just as much responsible for the prince's safe return. He has quite a few clansmen.
Careful, Varl King. This is the human capital and my generosity is really stretched thin.